5-time Commonwealth Champion, Abhijeet. This is simply unbelievable.
Feels good, like sounds good, like you know, 5-time, it's better than 4-time. So I was really lucky actually this time. I mean, normally they say that there is always deserving champion, but this time I thought I had bit of luck as well to go with it.
I think you are deserving because the way you played in the last round sealed the deal. You know, until then things were dicey. Against Swapnil, you had a winning position in the rook end game.
Well, I was sort of frustrated when I drew this game against Swapnil. Also, it was 150 moves. We played for 5 hours. And then at the end of the day, I had to make it. I mean, he defended quite well in the rook end game. And then, okay, I could not make progress. And for today, I just thought like I'd just go for a kill, because if I make a draw, I was not even sure whether I'll come in top 3, because such is the tie breaks, you know, Bukols, you never know. And I was just thinking I was just talking to myself that here I am playing this Commonwealth. Throughout the tournament I was playing on top board, and if I tie for first or second board, I played only last round I played on the second board, still I can be like outside the
out of the medal
contention. So it's like, yeah, I mean, such is life.
And Arjun is no pushover. I mean,
no, of course, he's quite a strong player, and I mean, he's very talented. I'm sure he's going to make a lot of noises in the future.
Right, so shall we go to that game? Because I think that game shows your character as such, where you win tournaments. Mm-hmm. And this was one more such game.
Well, okay, let's go through the game, but I would just say that such kind of approaches also backfires a lot.
Sure.
So I wouldn't really recommend it.
but you are like that kind of a person. Even if you lost this game, you would still go for it again.
Yeah, of course. My point is like, you cannot win everything. I mean, unless you're Magnus, you cannot really win anything. So my point is, let's say even in 3 or 4 tournaments, if you just manage to win that one last round game, if you're winning that, it makes sense to go for the kill rather than, you know, just make a tame draw.
So let's say 4 tournaments silver means less for you than like 3 no medals but 1 gold.
Yeah, of course. Like first is first and rest is rest. So yeah, let's go to the game. So when I was preparing, I had few options, but okay, this is what I play normally, and I had no reference where he was going to go here. He couldn't go Botvinnik, Moscow, which he played, or just simply knight bd7. But okay, in the game he went here. So this is typical anti-Moscow position. And I tried to surprise him with this move e5, which is very sharp. Again, we are playing for all 3 results.
I think h4 is a common move here.
h4, knight e5, castles, even queen c2.
Right.
So there are many moves here. Went for e5, knight d5, and knight d2. He went for knight d7, and I went a4, queen b6. There was one line which I was trying to avoid, which is, let's say I go knight e4, and he goes a5, and if I castle, he castles long. So I was trying to avoid this a4, a5. That's why I went in with such a move order. So in the game, a4, queen b6, I was not really sure what to do now. And I very well remember that in this position, a5 does not come. Like I have some tricks or something, which I still don't know what. I didn't have time to check my analysis or something. So I just thought I just played the moves which made more sense. AB, CB, and bishop f3. I just want to take twice on d5 and castle and push f4. This is my plan. Like very simple, but very hard to execute. So he went bishop b4, which is probably the best move here. I think I should have gone here knight d4.
And can you not take on d5 now? We are normal.
I can,
Indian.
But he can take like with both bishop and with the pawn. Let's say if I take knight d5, he takes with the pawn, and for me it's hard to defend this pawn. Like I don't know how to defend. And
can you start with bishop into d5?
I can also do that.
Because then
also
your
my problem
pawn
is my problem
free.
Is not this pawn. The thing is, if I castle after queen d4, let's say this. I cannot, you know, maintain the queens. That is my problem. I mean, the pawn on d4 is not that big a problem. But the problem is actually exchanging queens. So,
also, you would like your f pawn to be free, yeah?
Yeah, so. So, let's say I start with this. First of all, he can also take this. But also this, I didn't really refute this during the game. Like, I didn't know how to refute this. So, probably I have to take here. And again, the same problem. And I can't remove the queen because he just take bishop d2 check. So this was the basic problem like I faced after bishop b4. And I think I should have gone for knight e4 here. Still quite unclear, but I was not sure what to do after long castle simply. And this is not the position I actually wanted, like in my analysis or in the game. So I decided to take a bluff and just go castle, which is not
I could see from your face that here you were risking
it. Yeah, but it is not that easy practically. Let's say, so in the game he took bishop c3, he could take also knight c3,
yeah,
bc3, bishop c3, and now okay, this move was very interesting, rook a2. This is actually what my opponent told me after the game, but also this move I was not that sure like what is happening here. So queen d2 and I thought queen d5, and now
positionally you are just lost.
I have to mate him, so it's simple as that. So which makes it actually easier to play. So f4, and okay, he has some some practical problem at least. He cannot really close it because I always have bishop h4, so he has to somehow maintain this pawn on g5. So let's say if he goes rook g8 or something, I just go f5, and okay, it's a game. I understand that
maybe computers can
hold
this,
computer,
but
it would be like game over white if computer is black. But okay, practically I felt okay, I still have pretty decent chances. So so in the game he played bishop c3. I took on d5.
It was forced, yeah, because bc3, knight c3.
Well,
is
also this was very interesting. I was not really convinced. I mean, I didn't really refute this one as well. But during the game, I felt this is somehow more saner, you know, bishop d5. So let's say this line I was calculating, bishop f3, knight f3. And now I thought this is very clever. Because if I go back, he just takes the pawn. But my idea was anyway to go knight d2. Let's say if he takes on d4, I go knight e4. And yeah, it was not like I felt I have some composition. It may not be enough, but
I have played against you and I have played such a position where you had sacrifice. It's not easy. Like
yeah, it's
so
practically it's
threats.
Not easy. And also, it's like I'm just going to play positionally. I'm not trying to mate you. Let's say
positional
queen mate. b6, rook d1, and okay, probably first I'll give check and just rook d1. So
and you might also do king h1 f4.
King h1 f4. I'm going to play very slowly. So okay, if, like computer can defend this, but I thought over the board it's going to be very difficult for my opponent. But I mean, this was quite playable. Like if there was nothing else, I would have gone here. But what it so even this was quite interesting because here he could also take this, which I was surprised he didn't even give it thing for so long. Let's say take here, queen b7, rook b1,
c3,
yeah, c3, and I don't remember exactly, yeah, queen c2. Okay, it's again unclear, like I really don't know what is going on. Probably should take, but then I take on b2.
Yeah.
Here I'm only down a pawn, so
Yeah, but these three passers look really...
Yeah, but I think he has to give up this pawn. Because I don't know, like, after knight e4, it's going to be
correct.
Difficult for him. So this was another line, like... I mean, I'm not entirely sure, like, about the assessment. So, here he took bishop d5, bishop d5, bc3. Already here I felt quite comfortable because my plan is very simple. If he lets me play knight e4, I'm going to do it after queen e2. If he lets say plays queen c6, I'm just going to, you know, try to put knight on e4. If he takes, I take with the pawn, and he cannot castle queen side, he cannot castle king side. And I'm just down a pawn, and let's say even if he is safe like with a6 and long castle, this f7 pawn is quite weak. So this was my idea here. So he went for h5. He looked for counter play, I think, which is right. Went f3. And now I think he played h4, bishop f2. And he went for queen c6. Here I could have simply continued with my plan with queen e2, knight e4, but I felt this is even better. G4 is more or less forced. I mean, he could also play rook g8, but then I go queen c2, sometimes threatening queen h7, and like, okay, my idea is knight e4 anyway. So he went for g4, and this was quite strong. Probably he missed this. Like, once I get his king on e8, like, it's not, when it's not able to go to the queen side, I always have a decent counterplay. He went for rook h5, but I thought here there was some other move which I was not very sure. Probably rook g8 or something, but I'm not sure what is happening here.
Yeah, h4 is hanging, no?
Yeah, h4, just rook g8 back. Or maybe takes an h3 first. Probably this h3 and just chase the bishop, you know? Like bishop h4, just take this bishop and go long. So
even long castling rook's dangerous because a7 is hanging.
Yeah,
so.
I mean, but still, like, after rook a7, I still don't have a threat. Like, even if I double, triple, it's going to take a while. And in the meanwhile, he can start his counterplay on the king side. So I went for this, he went rook h5. Probably he missed this idea with f4. Bishop g2, queen g4.
This is all now concrete stuff. Right?
Yeah, this is very concrete, and I already felt quite good about my position. So bishop f1, probably more or less forced. Rook f1, h3. Like, he's threatening queen g2. So rook f3. Now actually he surprised me with rook g5.
Yeah.
I was not expecting this. I thought...
I mean, rook h8 if he goes.
Yeah, yeah. F5. I understand, like, after f5 it's just... yeah, it's very bad.
Very
but,
scary.
Yeah, just... But the problem is,
I mean,
somehow changing the queen, yeah.
Yeah,
exactly. That was my idea. Like, even after changing the queens, I'm probably mating him, or like, it's my pawns are queening.
So you would have gone for this.
Also, this was interesting, so I was not really sure. So, actually, my original idea was to play queen g5 here. That's why I was quite shocked when he played rook g5. But I somehow just couldn't really refute this. Like, a b4 and... I just didn't see how to, like, play this position. So, yeah, I thought for a while, actually, here. I spent quite a few minutes here, like... almost 10-20 minutes.
But FG5 has the advantage that you go knight e4 directly.
Yeah, and but my problem was long castle. He should have gone long castle here. And I was not sure, but I mean, I'm better, of course. Already I'm better, like, he should go rook f8. But it's a game, you know? Like, it could be anything right now. So, I could take rook h3 and, okay, it's a position. I don't know what is happening here.
Yeah.
But the way he played, I saw actually this before itself, that this doesn't work because of g6. Okay, he must take. And this was very strong, probably missed by him. So my idea is just to stop his king, again to run to the queen side. And like, mate slowly, like nothing forcing, just position knight coming to d6 and okay, it'll be mate sooner or later. So it took bc, and now I did a clever thing, like, because in time trouble, first of all, I'm gaining time, and also, let's say if I make some mistake, I remove the queen, he cannot castle long anymore.
Well, there have been instances where people have castle.
I was thinking about that during the game. So I like, let's make sure that he cannot castle later on. So went knight e4, c2, rook f1. Actually, here, there was, this was another interesting idea. Knight d6, queen d6, e d6, and let's say queens, rook f1, queen e3. But the problem here is he has knight f6.
Oh my god.
And this was like, we both were under 5 minutes by now. So
were you starting to feel like, oh my god, my title is in danger? Or
no. I always have a draw first. I mean, you don't think about titles when you're playing a game. Exactly. You feel you might lose the game. That is like bigger problem than, you know, all this titles. So here, so c2, I went rook f1. He should have gone for queen immediately. Yeah, but then again, I understand his problem. Like, I just take rook c1 and then come back with rook f1 and play positionally. So he went for g5, which is sort of clever, because he's telling me either take this pawn or let the king run away, you know. So, but I had seen this reputation like before itself. So, which is, actually it has a very nice reputation. So queen g5, so queens, I'll do with like this.
Just for the sake of clarity, queen into e4 doesn't work here.
Yeah, queen into e4 doesn't work because it's just simply mate here.
And
like knight f8, queen f8 and...
Sure.
Okay, I didn't even calculate this.
Yeah.
So rook f8 and rook f7. So c1 queen. So now this is very nice intermediate checks. Knight d6, queen d6, queen g6. Now king d8, it is forced because king e7, then I just take the queen. So king d8, I take the queen anyway. I'll just replace this. And he cannot somehow prevent the mate now.
Tremendous.
So queen e3 went, king h1, and actually, there was one clever defense. I mean, defense as in he can prolong the game with knight b6. And here, I don't know, there might be other wins, but I thought, okay, queen h7 should suffice, you know.
Keeping control of e4 square and...
Keeping control of e4 square and then, okay, threatening all sorts of mate. In the game, he played...
All of this happened in the game?
Yeah.
Okay.
He played queen e2, I think.
Okay.
And okay, now it's just mate. Queen g8, knight f8 and queen g5. I could also play queen f8, rook f7, but this is prettier. So
what a game. I mean,
it was quite complicated, to be honest.
I think you were in your best form today.
No, I wouldn't say that, because I have been suffering from flu since Goa tournament and still have some flu. I still have cold. But yeah, I mean,
such kind of games,
like, just adrenaline takes over. You don't actually need your energy. It just goes. You just go with it.
It's like these players like Federer or Nadal and all these guys. They raise their game when it's the most.
No, it's not
critical.
Like I rose my game for this tournament.
Not this tournament.
I mean this game.
The calculation.
No, the thing is
nice.
Like it was so complicated. I have to do it. I don't have any other choice. I cannot say, chalo, I don't want any more complications. Let's simplify it and do something. If I had a choice, I would have done that. But I don't have a choice here.
Okay, Abhijeet, thanks for showing this game. We want to ask you finally, Aditi, your better half is here. How was her support in this tournament?
No,
I saw her coming to the tournament hall. She was...
So every day she used to come here, like support me in every way. Like, let's say if I was not feeling well during the event, so she used to bring home cooked food for me. I mean, supporting me in all sort of way, like, cannot thank, like, I don't know how to thank her, because the way, the thing she'd do for me, I cannot replicate the same for her, so slightly spoiled that way. But yeah, I'm very lucky to have her.
I'm sure she's happy that she's married to Mr. Commonwealth. That makes her Mrs. Commonwealth in a way.
So Aditi, how do you feel about your husband winning the Commonwealth for the fifth time?
Okay, I feel great. I knew that he'll obviously win this one. Okay, I feel happy.
You feel that he, you felt that he would win it?
Yeah, obviously. I had that feeling that, okay, he'll get this title.
How do you get this confidence? Where does it come from?
I don't know. I mean, you know, we are like, I don't know.
You know him from many years and...
No, just 3, I guess. Yeah, from 3 years I know him. Like, okay, oh, he's...
Like, couple of years back. You met him.
Yeah, yeah.
You remember.
So I remember. Second time in
front of me. In 2017
he won, and now he's winning it 2019.
And how are you going to celebrate now?
Okay, we'll party, we'll go out, we'll have dinner.
Well, Abhijeet, congratulations. Thank you. Enjoy this victory.
Thank you.